has this, but we're gonna find out now in few seconds. And the civilizations are Aztecs, which is kind of expected. I will put LG because I prefer blue and red. And we have at the south we have Melo, at the top we have Dogao with red. Like I said, both Aztecs. I like this cliff here because he is palisading his clothes, and also if he put also palisade from the cliff to the forest is also close on the left. Don't like the goal, really really forward if you ask me. This forest is really nice because it's at the back and the berries as well, but all the goals and in these kind of battles are not in the best situation for Melo. Look at the other one on the right side, not the best as well. And I'm also trying to check the third one because no, it's here. Okay, it was a bit small and I didn't see. It's also really really forward. If we go for Dogao, we can see that he has a couple of hills at the back, which is not ideal. Look at that forest. That is okay, but it's not the best either. Just because of those hills, I don't like that. I think it's not the best for taking the wood. But this forest is really nice. The goal is forward, really close to the forest, so it's easy to defend, but forward is not ideal as well. If your enemy is going to rush, it's going to put you in problems. This goal is nice because if he palisade, he can go, even if he's really far, he could go for that goal if he's getting problems by Melo. But other than that, wide open map here. But overall, I think it's a bit better for Dogao. Not huge difference, but a bit better. Also, let's now pay attention for the boars. Both boars from Melo, really in the front. So if Dogao is going fast and aggressive with the eagle, he might take one boar for sure. Well, Dogao boars, one is really far but at the back, the other one is on a side but also far, but more complicated that he find it. I mean that Melo find it. Whoa, but they are sitting each other, the eagles. So but now no, now they are going to try to lame. Let's see, it can be. Okay, let's see. Let's go for the fog of war. He's going with the eagle, but now he's going to the wrong direction, so he's not going to take it. I think he's not going to take it. Now he's exploring all his base because he didn't find his own boar yet. Or he take it already. He take it, sorry. Okay, he took already and he still had the second one at the back. Now going for this. Okay, we are not gonna see lane, which actually I really love see the lane, because when you are here with Kesuni, he loves the lane. But for the game, in my opinion, it's better to don't see any laning and see a bit better balance match, because when you have one guy with three boars and the other with one, it's kinda, well, it's a big disadvantage actually. But oh my god, that maybe I have to change my mind, because Melo is almost there and he can see the boar. Oh my god, and I was telling that, but the laming is coming. Look at that. And he's still in the boar. I think he was really slow, man. Oh no, what the hell, look at this. And now he's gonna take it, and now he's gonna take it again. What the hell is going on? Look at this. And now he's gonna lose the crazy, and the boar went back. Oh my god, such a lucky Dogao. This never happened. What the hell was that? What the hell was that? He was taking the boar. He fired with the, well, he shoot, he was trying to hand and he take back. Oh my god. So no, I was right, so no laming. 21 population. I hope you hear me properly, because I will have to start to whisper really really soon, but this microphone, it might be okay for the whisper mode. Anyway, 22 population for both, making the barrack, also the militias already, little palisades already on the right side from Melo. Dogao is not doing any palisade, but he's making few houses in the front. Yes, he hit only once, man, I think only once, and for that probably he got it, because yeah, his scout didn't got any damage, I think so. No, he got some damage, but maybe it was from the eagle, I don't know. But he went back. Okay, Eagle from Dogal. He's with the militias already. Dogal, how many he has? Four, almost five already. Yeah, go away, man. And he's trying to bring the deers. Alright. I think he's going to bring the deers. And I think it's really good to do that. Population 31, 30. Pretty close for now. He's on the hill, which is really nice. Let's see if Milo is going to make another. Oh, how's it? Yes. He should make another, I think. Why you are making six villagers, man? Make the last militia. Oh, why four militias? I don't get it. Okay, he's fighting with four militia. He's gonna almost lose. Yeah, that was a sloppy. That was a sloppy, really. Yeah, that was a sloppy. Let me chat off as well. Now he's doing the feed, man. Oh, that was bad from Milo. Well, he has the eagle there. He's sending out to a villager. Good amount of farms. Dogal as well, but seems that like Milo has more. Alright. 33 population, Dogal 34. Yeah, but that militia almost dead. Well, Dogal. Yeah, you see? Almost untouched. And he's on the way to feudal age. The way to feudal age. Well, Milo is going to go up really, really soon. He's bringing and he's going. Yeah. And he killed, look at that micro, he killed that militia for free. Oh, but now the same, what the hell? Yes, man, that militia is almost gone. He want to kill the eagle, man. But kill that militia is almost dead. Kill the militia, and he got it. Well, it's quite close. Yeah, because they got the eagle, also one villager. Nah, it's okay, man, it's okay. Not big difference. Yeah, getting the militia, now with the eagle, and at the end, who win? Everything dead. Yeah, 29 population both, so both going, yeah, with like 25 difference, nothing else, and go, go, go. Let's check now the resources. Not any wall for Dogal, no. He's playing confident, seems so. Let's see if he's going to make now some walls there, or he's going forward. I don't know, because he's... two villagers. What is he doing with those two villagers? Or pelagers? Archery range, or maybe blacksmith? Exactly. Maybe he will make a house also here. I'm just guessing. Well, Milo is on field right now. He's gonna build in the front of the goal. No. Blacksmith and archery range. Yes, he did it. He did it. And it's a good choice from Milo. Five villagers on goal. Well, Dogal has six on goal, making second archery range. He's gonna make two houses and has completely walled, but he will chop the tree, all will also palisade behind. Two archery range and blacksmith. Okay, resources are looking pretty, pretty similar. I don't know if he's gonna make more villages, probably not. And trying to go castle age, so he's gonna go castle age a bit faster. A bit faster than Dogal. He's up to castle age, Mr. Milo. Alright, all right. Okay, if Mr. Yi or Tab are there, I forgot. Yeah, it's exclamation mark to put the spectator dashboard. Just tell me. It's really, tell me, Mr. Yi, if you are in the chat, how was the command? Because I really, really forgot now. And I will put to see if it's working for the viewers in Bully Official. Anyway. Two archery ranges and completely wall Milo. Or it seems so, yes. But Dogal is also walling. Yeah. I think he will make a house here because it's a bit risky to stay like that. Second archery range. Palisade, yeah, completely wall. 33 population and military. Villagers Dogal, two more. Well, for that it's a bit slower, so it might be worth it. Let's go for Milo point of view. Okay, exploration. Oh, he has nothing outside. Well, Dogal, not a lot either. Just sending the villager and walling. Well, this is pretty standard. The action usually start. Okay. Let me check. is like this. Just tell me if it's working, Mr. G. I did it, like you can see. Okay, crossbow is going from Melo. Also Fletchian. Botkin arrow. Whoa, that is the advantage. He's going for the Botkin arrow. Already super Fletchian. And that's it. Okay. Yeah, he's kinda stabilized the game for now. They are playing safe, both of them, I will say. But Melo has more reasons because he has the Fletchian. Dogao is with the super Fletchian. Okay, TC on the goal, which is very good. And also a bit in the front, who is it gonna defend even more if he's getting attack. Doing another? No. Dogao, let's see. Yeah, nice TC also for another goal and the wood. Bobso and gold mining from Melo. Interesting. Gold mining, whoa. Second TC. Crossbows out. Oh, not with super fletching, not yet. I like it that he's still on that hill, but he see that he's coming because he see the dead wolf. You see? And he can see there, stay on the hill, downhill, but super fletching, man. It's important, it's an advantage to be there, really. He's gonna lose another. He's gonna lose probably another. Yes, and he lost it, man. The plus two is a really big advantage. And he's there with Palisade only. Well, he can make two houses, but then it will be really close to the goal. Let's go for unit spy, and we can see what is he watching. Yeah, he's completely well. Siege Workshop, I think it's good to make that Siege Workshop, even more if he's going forward. But Melo, it's expected. Two houses. Yeah. Yeah, but he's not in the range to hit the villagers. Ah, Botkin arrow used when he's going there. Okay, look at the fight. He takes a little advantage and got one crossbow. Now he's wall. The problem is that the goal, now he's in the range. Alright, he has another? No. But he can make a mangonel. Yeah, another TC? Yes. 30 C, so really Melo need to make now some damage. Population differences, more army from Dogao, way more, 9 actually, and 4 villagers, 4 blockers. Mangonel there, and go back, yes, he need to go back, he still have good amount of army, man. But the Mangonel can change everything. Well, let's see if he can see it. Yeah, man, he can see the siege ward, so for that he's going back. Yeah, let's go for all visible. Oh, he's gonna meet that army? Maybe not. He should send now the mangonel forward. I think so, because he's already behind in the economy. So if he's not sending, well, he has 3 TCs as well. Will borrow from Melo, Tone Watch from Dogao. Love that upgrade. That upgrade is really, really strong. Look how he can see around the buildings. Yeah, it's really strong upgrade. People is starting to make even more and more when they see so many streamers and also some experts that they are doing that upgrade really quick. Also, even quicker than this and faster, really. Piper is usually doing really, really fast because look, he can see everything around if you are getting rash, and this is so important in this kind of game. One player down. Where is the mangonel for? Yeah, he has 2 mangonels. He has another goal here, so he's fine. But with 2 mangonels that he has, he should make some damage, really. Because he expended the resources on the siege workshop, also on the mangonels. So he should make some damage. Dogao is gathering good amount of resources. Look.
Dogao yes. Is trying to house all of South America as well, isn't he?
Yeah, look. all the Mac monastery now also building, and he would be completely
Melo.
Cool.
Yeah. Yeah, Milo's quite lucky that the guy was playing fairly defensive, isn't he? Because he's got so much extra military.
Yeah, but I would say that this is also in favor on Dogao, because Dogao is getting also good amount of resources and really better boon incoming. But Melo has 2 mangonels while Dogao doesn't. So in the fight with the 2 mangonels, he can have problems, and he has 10 players ahead. And if you check the popo, now the resources are getting closer. So let's see, but yeah,
Dogao's going to be clicking up to Imperial a lot sooner than Melo, though, isn't he? Why is Melo so far behind on villagers? I've only just caught that, man.
There was no any kill, so just better boom from the
Ah,
Jarl,
right,
because
okay.
it wasn't any kill, any raiding a big time, but well, it's true that Milo did the Siege Workshop early, so it might be that he got a bit behind. Now he's coming with the crossbows and he can make really, really strong damage there. Look at that, he's going, now he see it, nice. Let's go for the Fog of War, yeah, he saw it. He's coming back with the, yeah, but Dogao is
the ghost,
on the way,
yeah,
to
it just
video.
Clicked up.
Oh, and Dogao is doing the wheelbarrow now, while Milo did long ago. Sometimes I really don't know how to explain, because you can see that Milo has all the upgrades and he's also behind, but Dogao is doing now the one really important upgrade, but he's really going to Imperial. But all right, he's, because he did the three TCs right away, and in this fight, but he's so fast reaction.
Yeah, he went back quick. I was watching that as well.
Yes, I wanted, man.
Crossbows coming in.
You know, I have activated that the blood mod because I want to see the blood, man. Really, come on, come on, go now.
There's only a minute between them to Imperial Age, but the Gao's extra eco and village account is obviously going to come into effect at some point.
Yeah, I agree, but if he wall and his wall, you know, you need to, when you see that you are a bit behind and the scores say also that you are behind, just wall, man, to get time. Because actually, he did a boom as well, so if you wall and gather the resources and the military and you have a better micro in the fight, yeah, you can recover.
One thing I never get, and I know these guys are experts, they play a completely different level to us, but I don't get why Dogao is so far on top, so far forward with military, why he's not taking the map. Do you know what I mean? His villagers should be forward, building right on top of all the gold and all those hills.
You know why?
Right in front of Milo's base.
Yeah,
I never get why they don't.
But you know why? Because we see everything all visible. Ah, that was a bad shot, I mean, a bad move from Milo. Because we see everything.
Losing the mangonel.
We see everything, and they don't want to take the risk to send some villagers, and when you are going to build, get some surprise archers or something, so they play safe. I think that is the only reason, but because, of course, if you see everything and you see that he has the advantage like he has, you will go, but he doesn't know how much advantage or if there are army going around, so for that, they are just camping, patrolling a bit, and I think it's just that. Oh, that was a nice shot, and now be careful, mister. Ooh, that can be a change in the archer. Ooh, look at that shot, and but he's coming already with the
Eagles. Got elite Eagles running in everywhere
already.
Now, so
yeah.
Milo's gonna be
difference.
Behind on that.
Yeah, look at the difference in population, 107, 75. Whoa.
Every one of those crossbows now gone, look. Even though he did well there, Milo, he's just gone.
Elite Eagles also for Milo, plate mail armor. Whoa, both are doing the same upgrade at the same time, but population is 14 villagers.
Yeah, look at
and
the difference
military
in the military is
24.
Military, yeah.
Whoa.
Exactly, the guy was just flooding now. He's flooding and Milo's gonna stay. I just wish he'd come forward now. Now he really needs to go forward. Put everything on top of Milo.
He will try further raiding. I have used to see a lot of games with Aztecs War and they prefer to raid. And when they really feel the clear advantage that he has already, but even more, then they go forward. Because look at the map. Oh, this is like a run of ants. Look at this.
Yeah, almost it's almost like a goth player flooding the map.
Yeah. Okay, so he's raiding the TC on the goal. He's now going with some eagles. Well, it's a strong eagles as well. It's plus 4 elite eagles. Let's see what he can do.
Yeah, Milo's waited and played safe, hasn't he? Rather than just sending out army and losing it. But he's so far behind the girl with the push.
Well, he has almost half of the army, 20 by 40. So, how many barracks? Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 barracks. Well, he has good amount of barracks, but Dogao has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yes, he has a lot of barracks, and look at how much army, 40 population difference. Seems that the sandwich that Dogao take, it was good for him, right? Yeah, because look how he's killing, man.
Oh, it's getting worse and worse for Milo now, though, isn't it?
Well, the military difference is getting closer now. It's not that big anymore. It's only 16. Well, only. It's 16, but it was like 40. But the villagers and the economy.
Yeah, whoa. 27 villagers in front to go now. Obviously, Milo's getting hit. Not only is he behind on military, he's also getting hit.
Yeah, military.
He's trying to raid, if you look.
Oh, he's also raiding.
Trying to raid, but the guy's there as well, so it's...
And the GG, well played, alright. Well, it was pretty defensive game. Pretty defensive game, I will say. What we see usually in Aztec War, except if you go for push with Siege Workshop and so on. But yeah. Well, unit skill, not that big difference, so... Only 12 more. 78, 66, but probably all that kills was villagers. So, yeah, it makes that the difference in the economy, 3,000 food, almost 2,500 wood, and 1,000 gold. Yeah, it was a difference. And villagers, look at that difference. Yeah, was a difference, guys. So, 1-0, 1-0 for Mr. Dogal. And stay tuned, guys.
Very defensive.